Welcome to Heartfully Creating. Today it's a tutorial on another paint pen usage for the custom art cell phone case. This is what I use. So you can use any clear phone case. I like the silicone, and you need acrylic or oil paint pens, paper for your drawing, a UV clear coating like nail polish or UV resin, and some creativity. I did the drawing already. I'm not a big planner, as you know, if you watch this channel at all. I just drew some flowers and filled it in with lines. I like the silicone because it's more grippy than regular plastic. So after you draw whatever your image is, you can totally plan it. You can customize this and make a great gift. And make sure, though, that you do draw the lines on the inside, the part that touches the phone. And then I use black, but remember, that's the part you want to keep flipping it over to check, because that's the side that color is going to be seen first, and you're going to be laying down all of your other colors on top of those lines. Do whatever color you want. I like dark or indigo or a blue. You can even do it in white, but just play around with it. If you make a mistake, you can kind of like rub it off with water and a cloth or a baby wipe. So I just filled in the flowers with some line designs. And I'm also kind of doing a bit of a review as I do all these projects. So most of them I wrote down which paint pen. So the first one was a black Ohuhu. I find, again, Ohuhu is great for a great price, but a little more runny, so I had to shake it a lot more. The Artistro so far out of my usage of paint pens is my favorite. That and Aroic, A-R-O-R-C. And yeah, so I just kind of trace what I already drew, or you can totally wing it. You can do whatever you want. You can just color it in, but using acrylic or oil paint pens, it doesn't really matter. So I'm not going to bore you. I actually edited this to death. It was originally like an hour long, but I thought everyone will fall asleep. So if you really want to, you can, I think, slow it down or pause it through YouTube, but I sped up the rest of it as much as I could to try to just show the process, because I wanted to also try our new camera that does a lot better video footage without burning out. So all you really need is some creativity and some paint pens. You could probably do something like this with Sharpie pens, but the thing is with the acrylic paint or paint pens is you lay the color on top, as you'll see after, on top of those black lines once the paint is dried, and it doesn't take very long at all for the paint to dry. If you used a Sharpie, the Sharpie would kind of, because of the alcohol ink, this is just going to be a paint pen focus. The Sharpies wouldn't really work, but that's a whole other project for another time that I'm not really interested in doing because I'm working with the paint pens. So then I took it out once I was done, and I just finished in my lines, and I stopped tracing and just made up stuff and did what I want. I'm working on a silicone mat there, which is a good idea because I've already wrecked art. Remember that table? If you follow this channel at all or my Heartfully Creating blog, it took a really long time to redo our kitchen table into a galaxy glitter fest. Well, these paint pens, at least all the glitter and paint, helps to hide some of my accidents when I slip onto the surface of the table. But ideally, it's good to have something underneath, because acrylic paint on a smooth surface can sort of be scratched off. But I wouldn't play around with that if you don't want to ruin your table. Or most people probably have a craft table. Well, I have a great work desk, but again, there's a great video in my blog about the great desk my dad built me. But I end up always on the kitchen table for some reason, because when you use a wheelchair, for me as an artist, I like tabletops and surfaces everywhere because I can't lift my arms to reach cupboards for storage. So I kind of have everything all over the place, all my art making supplies. Poor Craig, he doesn't have much space. He gets a tiny little corner. So I just, if it's out of sight, it's out of mind for me, because it's like, I've got that art supply and that art supply. And being an artist, or even people who aren't artists who are just into like being creative and crafts and things like that, kind of can get a little addicted to art supplies. So you kind of collect them, buy them, mean to try them, and end up with a lot sometimes that you don't ever use. So if that's you, I'd love to hear from you in the comments below. And what kind of art supplies inspire you? And I would also like to know if any of you have tried paint pens and what do you think of them? Do you have any preferences and brands? I'm into using the affordable ones. Again, don't want to go into the Posca experience. Hopefully one day I'll get to try it again and maybe get a better set. I had to return the other ones. There's a video in that. If you're new here, I do this video is corresponds with my blog, www.heartfullycreating.blogspot.com, and there's a lot of stuff there. So yeah, so I'm just gonna draw, and I'm just gonna stop talking now and just show you, let you watch what I did, because there's not really anything else to say except shake your pen and shake your pen and shake your pen in between. Some of the brands you have to shake more, some of them not so much. And later on, you'll see that one of the tips they do, all of the brands I've discovered can dry a little. So you just kind of either use a bit of a wet cloth or rub back and forth on a piece of paper to get it going. And sometimes it's frustrating. I didn't have that happen. Like, so far it hasn't happened very much. It's just disappointing when you have your heart set on a color and you go to use it and you're not getting any of the paint out. But it does happen with all of them. So some brands more than others, but so far I won't pick on any certain brand. So here we go. Enjoy. And once you clean up your lines and everything looks great, then I started with the Heroic Teal. I don't go through every color. You can kind of see I just made up the name, so I don't know what the official name is, but the Heroic brand, because I really do like that brand the most. It was one of my first brands that I got. And I just started, again, no plan at all. I just start coloring whatever strikes my fancy, really. And I'm trying the Thule Art Ohuhu, an Artistro. And that's all I can think of right now. And as I go through it, you can just sort of see how it flows. I definitely think Artistro and Heroic are my top two of the ones that I've been reviewing. I still haven't finished the reviews because I keep getting sidetracked with these fun projects, because you got to admit it, doing projects is a lot more fun than swatching out paints and giving reviews. So I think what I might just do is, we'll see if it ever happens, but I'll just keep using them and mixing up the brands, because that way I also have more colors to choose from. So just make sure, I always flip it over to just look to see how it looks, because this side will be the messy side, the part that faces the ceiling. And then when you place it against the phone, yeah, it'll be all protected by the silicone or whatever material that your clear case is made out of. And you'll see at the end how I protected it. I'll let you know how I did that. All right, I am coming to the end of, I finally decided to stop recording. I don't know how people do it, but this is took me probably a good 2 or 3 hours because I don't know, I just did. So I like to try to create dimension. So I use some different color fields. I broke up the petals into different segments. And again, it's hard for me to go. I don't actually go this fast, of course. You know, I'm not the bionic woman. Yeah, and when you hold it up to the light, you can see where you've missed areas because I'm just using like the 0.7 millimeter tips. So they're really tiny. So at first it might look like, oh, I filled it all in. But depending on the technique you want, just hold it up to the light and you'll see anywhere that you missed. And for bigger surfaces, you can use the 3 millimeter or larger tips. It's totally up to you. It depends on your style, depends what you want to do. So yeah, so I'll just finish and I'm gonna jump right until today when I took some video of the I think it was today of the finished piece in the beautiful sunlight, which really brings out the color. All right, and before I do that, I'll let you know that I did finish when it was all done and dried. I took some Born Pretty top coat, the UV kind, or you can use a thin layer of UV resin and paint it on the inside. I didn't put it up the edges because I know you they have the spots for the buttons and stuff like that, so you don't want to kind of make it stiff. Or I was worried about some of the resin coming off into my buttons of my phone. So I just did the surface to basically seal it in a little bit. But I wouldn't mess around with it because it'll probably peel off because it doesn't usually stick to silicone resin. But it works for me because I'm just keeping it against my phone and it's nice and safe. So there you go. I hope you're inspired. And here's the
Okay, I
finishing
got the phone
part
case
where I
done.
recorded. And
Just want
this
to
is all
show you.
voiceover, but the rest
Okay,
is.
I love it in the sun. It's nice and bright. See, it's on my phone, which is, it needs to be polished. But here's the edges. And I used on the inside. Okay, first I'll just show you. Yeah, I wish I would have had the lighting like this when I was doing the filming yesterday. So you can see here just the vivid colors. I think it turned out really cool. So you can do your own. It only costs $3 Canadian for a silicone case. Here, I'll take it off to show you the inside. Okay, I'm doing this with one hand. So this is what the wrong side looks like, and you can see how messy it is. So when you do the cover, make sure you do what I normally never do, which is to pre-draw the design and then trace it, and then make sure your initial black lines or whatever outline you color you want to use are and that it's done well. And then because then every color you place on top of that, your black lines are still going to be there when you flip it over to the nice side. So yeah, so it's pretty cool. And two, I was worried about it peeling because it's acrylic paint. So I did put a layer of Born Pretty top coat that cures with a UV light, or you could brush on a very, very, very light coat of UV resin. But I would make it really light because you want something this is pretty is flexible. And I like the silicone covers anyway because they're a lot easier to hang on to because there's a bit of grippiness to them as opposed to a plastic cover. Look at that glare. Okay. It's just such a really beautiful autumn day with bright sun, which brings out the colors and everything. It's just so much more impressive. Okay. So yeah, so I hope you'll try that. I hope you're inspired to try making your own artwork on your a cell phone case. I know they used to do what they called, I think it was called Deco Den, and they put all these globs of things in decor. That's not my thing, but something that's nice and smooth and looks pretty and is a one of a kind work of art, yours. Or it would make a great gift for somebody. You could put names, you could personalize it, whatever. It is a lot of work, but it's worth it, especially if you have fun doing it. So there you go. So I hope you learned something and I hope you're inspired.